children there during it. And I just grew up always knowing that I was going to go to college and be a doctor or a teacher, because my dad was a doctor and my mom was a teacher. So when I got to college, I realized that I didn't want to do either of those. But to backtrack, at 15, I had my first child. At 16, I got married. 17, I had my second child. At 24, I had that one back there filming. And when she was 6 weeks old, my husband and I separated. I didn't have a job. I didn't have a degree in biology, because when I got married at 16, my daddy told me, you can do this, but you got to go to college. And I'm going to pay you, because you got to go to college. And I said, okay. Because I was always good in school. I was a straight A student. And everybody was shocked that I got pregnant. You know, like, I didn't have hormones. But anyway. So, real smart, you don't have hormones. So, after my divorce, my daddy, you know, he's a good daddy, what can I say? He helped me, and he said, I'll help you, but you got to figure something out so you can take care of these kids. Because we all know child support doesn't go too far. Mm-hmm. So, I went to nursing school. I had a biology degree because I was going to go to medical school, which I decided not to do. You'll learn I've changed my mind a lot of times. So I could say, okay, I'll go to nursing school. So school is easy for me, and I'll admit that. I can go if I want to do it, I can graduate. So I went to nursing school so I could take care of my kids. I figured that was a stable job. I would always have a job. It would be easy to get a job, and I was right about it. So I was raising my kids and nursing, and then I decided, man, I don't like this. I was good at it, but I didn't like it. And I had always growing up been the type of person that would like go to Walmart somewhere and be like, man, I can't work a 9-to-5. I'm just not made for this. I don't want to be a person that just works a job and then I die. I mean, that's just the way my mind always worked. I don't want to just work a job and die. I want to leave a legacy. I want people to remember I was here. But I couldn't figure out what that would be. I was always good at writing, but I mean, who makes a career out of writing besides James Patterson? So I didn't think that was possible, but I was like, okay, you know what, I just keep doing this and take care of these kids, it's working. So my oldest daughter went to school in Hampton, Virginia, and it was like I didn't know kids grew up. So I was like, she's grown now, what am I supposed to do? And I guess I was having like this existential crisis of what am I supposed to do with my life? I can't keep working this job I don't like. I had several nursing jobs. I believe you, I tried to like it because I had several of them. And then I decided, I prayed. I was like, Lord, you put me here for something. It wasn't nursing because I wouldn't be this miserable doing it. Whatever it is, can you show it to me? And the first thing that popped in my head, you always been a good writer. You always go